Hi, it's Barton James here from Line of Sleep, and in this video I'm going to demonstrate to you the utility of linear EBUS. This is a bronchoscopic technique which utilises ultrasound to be able to biopsy structures within the lung and within the thorax and mediastinum. This is a really great tool for biopsying lymph nodes in the chest, and also biopsying lung lesions. So I'll use a case study to demonstrate how it's done, and I'll show you a video of the procedure itself, and in the end I'll show you a few additional techniques that we can use to advance the bronchoscopic technique of linear EBUS. I hope you enjoy it. So here's a case study of a 76-year-old man who was an ex-smoker of 40-pack years and presented with 4 months of cough. And on the CT scan, there was a left lower lobe lung mass. Here's the CT. Now, to orientate you, this is the front here with the sternum. This is the back with the vertebra. The lungs are in here. This is the heart in the middle, and this is the left lung. Now, this white area of abnormality here is the abnormal lung mass. You can see here that there's an airway leading into that. So bronchoscopically, especially with radial EBUS, we could biopsy this by putting the bronchoscope into the left lower lobe airway, using the radial EBUS to confirm our position and biopsy this. However, this is the mediastinal windows. Now on this CT, we've blacked out the lungs, so we don't get any definition of what's going on in the lung, but we do see more about what's going on in the mediastinum. This is the ascending aorta and the descending aorta, which is white because of contrast. Now in here is a lymph node. Now this lymph node is the right paratracheal lymph node, or 4R, and it measures 12 millimetres, which is slightly larger than normal, and that's concerning in the setting of probable cancer, that there could be a metastasis to that lymph node. And sure enough, that's confirmed on the PET scan. And this is the PET scan that goes bright yellow in areas that are highly metabolic of glucose. And this lymph node is highly metabolic, and that's very concerning for a spread of a cancer. So instead of biopsying the lesion in the lung, it's important that we biopsy this lymph node, because that will confirm whether or not there has been spread to the lymph node, which will certainly change the treatment. So this is linear EBUS. And this is how we're going to biopsy that lymph node. This is the EBUS scope. It's a bronchoscope with a camera at the end here, but at the tip it has an ultrasound. And out of the scope comes a needle, and the needle comes out in direct view of the ultrasound, so we can needle mediastinal structures on the other side of the airway, confirming the position on the ultrasound, and we can watch the needle. And this is just demonstrating that this is the ultrasound transducer, and it shines ultrasound in a linear fashion. Here's the procedure. This is the endobronchial view. You can see a little balloon there that's covering the ultrasound, and this is the ultrasound view. So we know that the right paratracheal lymph node is just going to be up here somewhere. This is the sheath of the needle. Now that just protects the scope from the needle, and that's where the needle is going to come out of. So we want to look around here. Then on the ultrasound, we can see this is blood vessel. Now that's the lymph node. That's the lymph node we're concerned about. Doppler confirms that it's not a blood vessel. This is the superior vena cava running longitudinally along the trachea. This is the oesophagus vein. And this is the 4R, or right paratracheal lymph node. The ultrasound shows it looks a little bit heterogeneous, and it looks concerning for a possible metastasis from that lung cancer. There's an area of darkness within the node. So now what I'm going to do is put the needle in, and the needle is going to come from here, and it's going to push straight in. There it is. The needle has come straight into the lymph node, so I can very easily see and very safely biopsy the lymph node, even though it's surrounded by vessels. So once the needle's into the lymph node, we can then needle it a few times to aspirate cells out of that lymph node. ROSE stands for Rapid On-Site Evaluation, and this is where we have a cytologist in the endoscopy room to rapidly screen aspirated material to ensure that we have a diagnostic sample and that we have enough sample for all the additional testing that will be required on those malignant cells. And this is an example of the on-site cytology. You can see that there are some lymphocytes here in the background which are normal, but here in the middle and over here are clumps of large abnormal cells with pleomorphic nuclei that look clearly malignant. So we know that we're in a lymph node, and we know that we've got aspirated malignant cells out of that lymph node. And this turned out to be adenocarcinoma of the lung, and it was stage 2A. And given that the mediastinal lymph node on the right side was abnormal, that means there's a contralateral mediastinal lymph node metastasis, which stages that as N3 and no metastases. And this patient was in good performance status, so it was treated with a combination of chemo radiation with curative intent. Now don't forget linear EBUS, because it's not just for nodal biopsies. Here is a situation where we have a lung mass, but you can see the lung mass is actually in direct contact with the trachea. So we can sit our linear EBUS scope here and put the ultrasound against the trachea, and I'll be able to see that mass, and I'll be able to needle that through the trachea. And that's a really easy way to biopsy it, rather than a CT guided biopsy that has to come across lung, pleura and fissure, or trying to navigate back to that lesion at the top of the lung with radial EBUS. So this is a great case for linear EBUS. We can also use the linear EBUS scope in the oesophagus, and we can perform EUS. And for thoracic lesions, this is a great technique. Now here's a lung mass, which is a difficult area to access, but you can see that it's in direct contact, really, with a little bit of soft tissue between it and the oesophagus. So by putting the linear EBUS scope in the oesophagus, we'll be able to see that lesion, and we'll be able to very safely needle it straight through the oesophagus. Here's another one with a small peripheral lung lesion here, which on the PET scan is highly avid or highly metabolically active. You can see there's a little bit of faint yellow tucked right in there. And that corresponds to this node here. Now this is a paraesophageal lymph node. Not very commonly involved in lung cancer. It's very important to biopsy that to see if it's a metastasis. And the oesophagus just sits here. So using the linear EBUS in the oesophagus, we'll be able to biopsy that lymph node. And here's a tricky case. How are we going to get to this lesion here? There's background of emphysema, so we don't want to put a CT guided biopsy, which would come through the lung and through a lot of lung and put the patient at high risk of pneumothorax. Here, it's not in contact with the trachea, but it is just in contact with the oesophagus. And this is a case I actually performed recently where the EBUS scope was able to be put into the oesophagus. You push the oesophagus across just enough to be able to put a needle into that, and that turned out to be an early stage adenocarcinoma of the lung. And the last case here is an FDG avid lung lesion in the left lung. However, this here is a big adrenal metastasis, and we can biopsy the adrenal metastasis by putting the linear EBUS scope through the oesophagus all the way down into the stomach and navigating around, and I was able to biopsy the adrenal gland that achieved a tissue diagnosis, confirmed the presence of the metastasis, and meant that we didn't have to biopsy this lesion, which is in a tricky place to access. So I hope that video helps understand linear EBUS and its utility to biopsy lymph nodes within the chest and also lung lesions. Prior to linear EBUS, lymph nodes in the chest would require mediastinoscopy to biopsy. Now, there's certainly no role for mediastinoscopy these days in the initial evaluation or biopsy of lymph nodes within the chest. So make sure you or your patients do not undergo a big surgical procedure which requires a cut across the top of the neck to biopsy the nodes in the chest, when bronchoscopy with linear EBUS is by far a safer, less invasive, superior technique to biopsy these structures. I hope you found that interesting, and I hope that hopefully it was useful. Please let me know if you have any questions in the comments, or if you have any other videos you'd like or be interested to see about case studies in respiratory medicine or sleep medicine. I'd certainly be happy to do that. And I'd always love you to subscribe to my channel. Okay, see you later.